points on the list. Living in here, but still get a spread. Started with a little, but still reinvesting. Fear how I feel, then you feel less blessing. I just want the lesson, I just want protection. I'm up and I'm down, but the sound like progression. Farmer never plans if he waits for perfection. Finger to the down, hold it.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, I hope you're having a wonderful day. Today, I want to go over the Robinhood account, and I want to go over some of the recent trades that were made, as well as some of the options that I'm going to be holding towards the end of the year. So there's a lot of stocks, as you can see. We're going to go over some of the more recent ones. So depending on how active you've been with the stream and everything else, give you a little bit of an update. We do make a lot of other trades on the other account, and I will make another video on that one if you guys want to see a little bit of insight. I was going over, you know, where some of the losses, and even on this one, about 50% of the losses have actually came from stocks instead of options, even though I do trade some options on here. But the Robinhood, we've had a lot of back and forth with it, and it's kind of good to see us get the gains and keep it. But now I want to just give a little update coming into the end of the year here, and given the fact that today what we saw, it's going to be very straightforward for tomorrow. We're getting a triple witching, so definitely keep your eyes out for that. There could be a little bit more volatility, but overall the market is just going to be getting ready for Powell tomorrow. So I got all of the options here. We're going to go over some of the open option trades, and then I'm pretty much going to start more towards the bottom of the list, and you could see some of the shares we made. I think Zyme is probably the most recent. I made this one in July, so I think the last 2 or 3 months we could go over them. Most of them you guys would have saw, and it'll be a long video going over all of this, but hopefully you guys can learn something from this. Give me your feedback, and hopefully it can inform you. And don't forget, we are live Monday through Friday, 30 minutes before open. Drop your thumbs up. Oh wait, I'm not supposed to say that, but youtube.com/thestockmarket. We will see you there in the morning, baby. But coming to the options over here, this one is going to be very, very interesting. I did notice that we also have one big option trade. Remember, this is a joint account I have with some of the real estate guys at the office. I do take full responsibility, and I do know what's going on most of the time, but they had a $5,000 option loss here. So the account would be a little bit better, but I'm pretty much going to be starting here at October, because most of these ones that are expiring tomorrow, they're going to be wiped away, and their zeros are already factored into the balance. So all of these are complete losses at this point. But coming into the first trade on the option side that I'm holding, we got these Pelotons. These are down 50%. They're going to be expiring next week, or in October 15th, but we got some of these puts, and this was reacting to that one day where you heard their accounting issues after earning. They said they had a material accounting misstep or something like that. So I got to buy two of these calls. They were only worth $40, or that's how much I'm down. I spent about 80, so we got that. The next open play that I'm holding here is AT&T, the $29 calls for October 15th, and we got this after that, or the week after that Warren Buffett news. So remember, I was expecting some slow delay, and I actually might even want to add to something like this or get more time, but down $120 on that one. Then our UUP play, down 40% as well, and I'm also sure there's some gainers on here. I know I'm starting off with the losses, so hopefully you guys aren't like, wait a minute, all of these, just wait, okay? Don't worry. But this was the UUP play. This was like our most recent addition in August when we talked about it about a month ago. And I said about like $500, $1,000 of insurance. I spent $500 October 15th. Remember, the other ones I got January. So this was more of a shorter term one. But these ones, I'm down 40%, another $200. Then we got our Affirm play. So you see a lot of those smaller plays, those are nice. But this one, $55 into $1,300. And I'm still holding it, as you guys notice. And I still have the value. So it says I'm up about $1,200 on it, but then we ghetto spreaded it, so I'm down about $200, so I could pretty much get $1,000 net profit. We're holding that there. And since I got $650, I cannot lose more than $600 on this full play. That'll be my bare minimum floor as far as profit. So these are the Affirm plays. Then I'm holding these Netflix. Oh, these ones came down. I thought these ones were up. But we bought this one. It had a lot of time, but I got this one in March 12th. And I bought two of them for $3,600 a pop. So you can see I spent $7,200. And this was pretty much in the middle of March, all that hype, getting some of that inflation, the growth after we saw a little bit of that rotation. I said, okay, let me get a contract with time on some of the bigger tech. I chose Netflix. Should have probably gone with Apple, Microsoft, or Amazon, but these ones are a decent price. Spent $3,200, and then before their earnings on April 20th, I sold one out for $100 more. Wanted to trim the position, and then Netflix dropped. So I was like, okay, held this one out. This one ended up dropping a lot, actually. I think I was down to like $600 on it, but recently it came back. And again, I'm pretty sure I was up on it. I thought I was, but we came pretty close there. Then it dropped. So this one has a decent amount of time left, but we're going to see how this one plays out through the end of the year. But I'm still live in that one, and that one expires January. And hopefully you see by now the only open options that we have here on the Robinhood account, I'm already at January expiration. So keep that in mind as far as time is concerned and everything, because yes, there's been a lot of moves, even if there's other bigger lost trades. And again, imagine all of the equity in different stocks that we have on here. This account has stayed relatively stable, or at least, you know, we've held that 140, you know, I guess 120 would be the resistance, but I've always viewed that like 140 mark as a very, very key level from when we were here and then fell out and then we broke past. That's doing my own technical analysis. So keep in mind the amount of time. And now going into more time, here's the NEO play. I grabbed NEO puts at the beginning of the year. You know, I've never been a fan of it, so I was like, okay, I'm gonna grab some of these. I did average down on these on the TD Ameritrade account, so we'll go over that one when we get to that video. But sadly, I still like this play. I know some of you may not like that, but you know, I got to pay for it. You know, I paid for my beliefs. Amen, amen. But this play, I grabbed 20 of the contracts at 63 cents a pop, spent $1,200. It's worth 260, and that's probably something you guys can notice on a lot of these plays. You know, depending on how they are, you could always liquidate them. I mean, I could get $36 for that right now, another 160, you're at 200 bucks, take 50% of that, that's another $500. Then we got the Affirm, I could take it up the other profit. That plays up though, but the overall logic is that some of these still are holding value, and the point is they still have time. And if you know my strategy, and this is highlighting it right in front of you, I am ready to lose anything I buy, and that's why none of this is a recommendation. Options trading shown the risk, because the most financial advisor, the sole financial advisor, educational purpose only, thank you for today. But in all seriousness, you guys have watched me over the years, and this is exactly what I do. I am either going to take profits if it goes up and I can make it free, I could ghetto spread it, we could do stuff with it. Otherwise, if that play goes down, I am fully aware of how options work. They are designed to go to zero, so I am expecting to lose all of them. And that's why, even though I could probably salvage some money on these, I don't like to cut them out, because we've seen random moments where they have came back to life again. That Netflix example is probably the best one, because like I showed you, at one point this was just worth $600. Maybe now would be my time to exit, or again, it did go up to $3,000. These are worth a lot more. So that is just how I am going about playing it. So make sure you know your strategy, or if you are trying to learn the way that I've traded and kind of follow along, what you got to make sure of is don't put an amount unless you're willing to watch that go to zero and will actually hold it till zero. And that's why what you put into it is what you need to do. You know, again, a big thing we always preach is that cash balance, making sure that there's always going to be cash available so you could trade. It gives you idea. And even then, in this case, the cash balance is pretty low. However, if you have been watching along, you know, I have actually went towards a lot more shares on this account, and I'm being pretty choosy with some of the options there. So keep that in mind. But now coming to the next play, my EEMs, these ones we grabbed at the beginning of the year. And these ones came back to break even when there was volatility, and then they dropped. I mean, when was it? About a month ago, they came right back up to 20 cents. So at some point, you know, I got these as an insurance play at the beginning of the year, looking at the emerging markets and all that. And it's ironic to see some of these plays are coming to life, but we were about a year early. If we're looking at what's going on overseas, China, all of that, and how virus and everything else is impacting it, it's hitting the overseas markets a lot more. But this is what happens when you play options and you are forced to be on a clock. But this play down 1600, the part that I don't like is that it's down, but like I'm showing you just a month ago, if any volatility really did pick up, this thing within 2 days was just ready to come back to break even. So it gave me that exposure and insurance that I would have probably been looking for. So you saw random little spikes and it did it a couple times. So keep that in mind. But that was the EEM play. Then XLF, I just made this play not too long ago, I think about a month ago. And this one has kind of fluctuated. We'll see over the last month. I bought it at 74. It went up here to like 83. Came down to about 62, not 50%, but probably like 30. Came back recently a little higher, and then even there, the price we paid is literally the midpoint, so we are break even on this one. So I'm still holding this play in the banks, and this was in relation to the tapering and everything that was going on about a month ago as we were coming into Jackson Hole and all of that stuff. So keep that one in mind. Then Dropbox, I thought this one would be worth a little bit more, but it says I'm down 10%. This one expires in 2023, and I have a $35 call, spent $348. That's what it's saying it's worth, or $315 now. But if you actually look at this play, I was able to make these free. So if you come down here, you can see I spent about like $7,200 to get 20 of these contracts back in the day there, December 14th. And then it shot up by February to $470. I sold 15 of them. got back 470, and then I got back another four of them for 1600. So I collected $8,600, spent 7200, and then I'm left holding this. So even though I'm down on it, it's holding a value. This was an overall positive play, but then it leaves me with a free option for the next two, three years. So I'm just comfortably riding that out. So there's that one. Then DraftKings, this one's an interesting one. This is a leap, and I didn't do anything with it. I bought this January 14th. I bought three of them for $1,800 a pop, 5,400 total. They're down 31%, 1,700. These ones, I just never made free. And again, this one has till 2023. We were liking DraftKings a lot, and we were playing that in general. And that was just the overall logic. I think at one point, they did shoot up a lot, down to up to even 2,800. But that was in October. I think here in January and March, I could have got 2,800. I could have made these free, but my idea was I was just going to hold DraftKings in general. So at the time, this was an in-the-money leap, so you get to see its performance now, but still rocking with that one. And then Tesla, I grabbed my big Tesla puts end of December. Again, kind of like Neo, I was a little bit more of an Elon hater. Ironically, again, and even in this case, I could sell out of these and get $1,000 if I really wanted to rebalance, get more cash, and balance things out. But on this case, I'm down $2,000 on this, but I still have the time on it. This one's a little bit out there, $100 put for 2023. So these would hold up very awkwardly throughout time. I think at one point they kind of would just go up, but you could kind of see as Tesla has gone on, it's really these hold value with volatility, but it's seemingly just the time decay, 1 year of time absolutely killing and wrecking these. But there is that one. And then Uber, we went over this play the other day. This one was a leap, down 44% on that one. But again, in this situation, bought 10 of them for 13.5, sold 7 at 12.7. I got pretty much this play for like $600. So it's saying 4,000, but again, we made them free. I could sell out of them at 2,200. But just like the DraftKings, these are two long-term plays that I wanted to add to the Robinhood account because I believe in them. I want to hold them. So still riding this in and out with Uber. And then recently we just made this play. Here is that Airbnb 185 leap for 2024. So an extra year of time, but got a nice little gain of $1,500 on it. We will see how this one plays out. It is definitely too early to tell, but now coming into some of the equity that I'm holding. Like I said, I'll start with that like ZYME. I think some of you remember like the UAVS shares. We had these. Or I guess we'll start with Valander. I think that's a decent one. We're down 40% on that. And the logic with a lot of these, because again, you see the options. Some are expiring. You could lose money real quick, but you'll see what's going on with some of these plays. But over time, you know, we've seen a couple of these end up popping. But when you have equity, you're going to get more stability. And that's one thing I like to do. Even if I make option gains, I'm still playing options. I'm still taking a lot of shots, if you couldn't tell. But at the same time, I'm making sure I get a big baseline to support me there with the equity. So Valander, we bought this one. I thought it was a hype play that really, really fell off. So I figured at like $9 again, I think it was around here, but I did not buy that one in March. I bought this one in June, on June 8th. So you could kind of see where it's at. We got in on that first little pop, but then it has continue to drop a little bit since there, a lot, down 42%. But in this case, it is equity. So even though it's unfortunate that I am down on this, I do plan to actually hold this one for a decent amount of time. So there's Valander. I got to get the tabs ready for you guys so we can make this faster. But now the next play, UAVS, this one we're down 40%. I think we were up on this probably like 100% at one point, I want to say, June 15th. I guess it was only a slight gain, but one thing you'll notice with this play, this was only $500. I bought it at $592, so even 46%, down $273, and that's one thing we always talk about is this small share strategy. And now, some of them I go smaller than others, but especially on some of the hype names, and you'll see, I wanted to get exposure, but what I made sure I did was I kept them really small because, yes, I am down 40%, but compare that to now some of those options, they are going to expire, whereas if any of these ever do come back to life, we will be able to make them come back, or they will actually be able to work for us. So there's that one. Then Zyme, I'm down 5% on this one, $200. This one's a little bit more expensive, but again, same logic there with the shares. We grabbed this one on July 1st, and I believe they got this was in response to some of the biotech stuff or phase 2 or 3 or something along those lines. Again, any of the biotechs, I've grabbed a couple of them, even the next one, I see we did the same thing, but we've seen a lot of hype in the biotech space. So some of them, there's been a good result in market reaction. I was making sure I'd grab at least 100 shares or maybe less. It all depended, but keeping it small. In this case, you're seeing, you know, down 5.2. We bought it at 38.35. It fluctuated. I'm sure it was down a lot more there, more than $5 per share or $8 per share. So it's down at like 800. But again, that 1 month could change a lot. There is no expiration, so able to ride that out, but still holding this play. Then IC, we did this one the other day, but I bought it around the same time, July 6th. I bought 200 of these at $8.97. And again, if you will go look at the chart, you'll even see the same thing. I mean, July, here we got it after the run-up. Again, phase two or phase three study. Then it started to drop again. I think at one point you're probably down just a little bit. This one held up a lot better, but then it shot up that one day, and I was able to sell 100 shares at $14.14, and now I get 100 of these shares for free that cost me nothing. I'm going to hold those forever. Then Wilhelmina, this one went back and forth a lot. This one would just get halted. I know we were up on it at one point. We even doubled up. I decided not to sell it, but I grabbed 200 shares July, still holding, and then I'm down 15% or $200. So again, the percentages might look scary, but when you control them here with the balance, you know, my initial investment was about $1,200, $1,300. So it's not too bad in the sense of comparing that to an option. I could buy it for a couple hundred, just like the Tesla. I could spend $3,000 and then boom, you could be down 50% very quickly and it'll stay like that. So keep that in mind. Then there's Oser. This one, I put in 1,000. I thought this one was the bad one, but see, this one still held up the same. Again, we got this one July 16th, there was a lot during that time. And if you haven't noticed a couple of these, you know, I think already three of them of this list are biotech or medical related, considering some of the hype. That's why I'm getting exposure to them. And I'm making sure just 100 shares at a lower price, I'm not risking 1,000. And the only way I lose that 1,000, if it goes to zero. But as you can see, it's just all about playing the time. So up $50 on that 4%. We'll see how this one plays out. But this one was the bad one. This one just went down 50% right after I bought it on the same day. So I got them off of the hype. Again, they got some announcement of like CBD and getting to use it over in some area. Again, I'm forgetting. I cover them all on the watch list. So if I do take some time to go and think back, I have the reasoning and logic we've documented on all of them. But this one, I just lost 50% right off the bat. But again, $4 a share, 200 shares. I only spent about $800. So the $500 loss sucks, but getting to ride this one out. And hopefully too, even by this point, I'm hoping you can realize that none of these losses are trying to be justified. I'm fully ready and willing to do it. I just, you know, my reaction to them isn't going to be anything from, you know, I expected this to kind of occur. This is why I keep them small. And the overall logic is the account still keeping our money? You know, am I still able to expose myself to opportunity, but at the same time, my account is still continuously up? It may be down from where the year started with some of the other gains, but overall, at the end of the day, this was a $40,000 account when we started it, and now it's gone to this amount. But now, if you think about it, this was in May 2019. We have already surpassed May 2021. So this has been 2 years of taking 40 grand and then turning it into 143. I mean, it's really just about 50 grand a year. Some people want to look at that, but again, we never say you're not supposed to live off of this. You know, imagine if you were able to go about, and a lot of it, we had a couple of big share plays or option plays, but the shares were able to do a lot of work and keep us up here. But this is just an investment trading account. You add this on the side of anything, it's not too bad, but clearly, you know, there's a lot going on with it. But hopefully you guys are aware that, again, I don't want it to see, you know, I'm talking about some of these losses. I'm like, well, it's down this and this. You've seen more losses than not, and hopefully you guys can respect that. I am trying to show you what I am holding, but at the same time, you could also see strategy and capital allocation within this. I am not expecting to not lose, and that's why I'm going in with smaller amounts. You know, I'm not trying to swing for the fences on all of them, so you got to really factor that into play. But then moving into the next one, this is the one I got clapped on, and I lost more on the option than the shares. I grabbed 100 shares, only down $100, but we played this as a buyout rumor, and then you see where it's at. And then the other day, I picked up 100 shares or 200 shares of BFly, $12.74, and this was because they got some mentions in the Apple thing. But I'm sure we'll take a look at this one in a couple months like we do with these, and we will see where they're at. So hopefully this gave you some insight into what I'm holding. And that way, some of you were asking, you know, some of the more recent stuff. You got to see all of the options. You're getting to see, again, a lot of these other stocks. I mean, if we go through it, they eventually kind of ended up with what we have here. You know, not every single one of them went up. A lot of them we were able to make free and do some stuff. But I could quickly go over all of these. I just won't explain it. I'll just go down to the gains, and we'll see what we're working with, because as you see in the market, it only takes a couple of good opportunities. And by going through that, you know, you could actually take it a pretty long way. Oh, and it looks like I actually forgot this. Here was Robinhood. 17% gain, but we got these shares for free. Again, there's so many shares in this account, but we did the same exact thing where we bought 100 shares, or I think I bought like 250, or I bought 150, then I sold 120, got 30 shares for free, get to hold this for the rest of my life. It's still worth $1,200. Nautilus, this was the Amazon play, down 26%. I may even add to this one. I actually like it. But this one, again, another loss there, $1,200. Then I think we stopped at AC Immune and XL. Then, yeah, we were right here. But now, here are the other trades. As you can see, you know, this was Workhorse, $100 into $830, but this was up a lot more at one point. But again, if you do hold them as long as I do, you know, you get the ups and downs. So that's part of it. But that was one again. And these are all from years ago. And at this point, too, I have also sold covered calls on this to get a pretty decent amount. We hit that one big play, but I bought these on May 2019 for $100 on that. And that's why, you know, playing time in the market, you could actually go a pretty long way with that. And then our Snapchat, this one is about 4,000 into 20K, $14,000 gain. We get to ride that one out forward. I'm up only 11% on this one, 500 shares there, but that's a bigger amount. Gap, we got this one for free. We did this during that Mr. Beast thing. And now this one even pays dividends, but I bought 1,000 shares at 1,270 or 12,900, sold 750 for 13,100. So I got to keep 250 shares for free. Get back $200, $300 more than what I spent. And then now it's paying me dividends. But as you see, this is literally now a $6,000 position and it's just able to work for me. So hopefully you guys are getting the full picture of this. I know I wanted to start with the losses first because if you already clicked out, you know, you're not going to really get the idea. But hopefully you are seeing the power and impact of time here. And by going and keeping the same way I'm operating, there is going to be losses. But by staying alive and making sure I'm not going too big on anything and being patient enough, I'm still staying in the game. And now you're seeing some of the winners emerge. And now they get big enough where they could do a lot of work for you. Here's Abivi. We're getting drip on it. It even dropped recently about 10-15%, but still got 20% on that one. Then we got Inovio. This one, I did come back to break even. I think I made these ones free, or did I sell a cover call? I guess I just bought these and I didn't. But that one, again, it's related to some of the vaccine stuff, but still even 2%. At least I got my money still staying, hanging in there. So we'll see what happens. Then Co-Diagnostics. This one's a loser. Again, 32% there, but 100 shares, $1,470. $1,400 investment. And a lot of these too, I did have opportunities to either take profits and then sometimes I would make them free. In this case, I didn't. If we go down to TXMD, this one's down 59%. March 5th, I actually don't even remember which one this one was. But as you can see, a lot of them are usually pharma companies. Corbis Pharma, this one's just break even right here. There's no history on this one. I only have one share. I think this is like a reverse, or I think this was like probably a free Robinhood share. No idea what that is. Then Applied DNA, down 25% on this one. We only spent $600, so held that in that time frame as well. Then Vaxart. This one was 10% down, but these ones I got to make free. I remember that. I bought 500 shares for $4,600, sold out 300 for $4,800, got a $200 profit on that. So still overall up on it, but then I got to keep $1,600 of free shares and have exposure during that whole time to one of these vaccine stocks. Then BGSM, I remember this one. Terror Squad one, I got this one a little bit bigger, but I'm down on that one. We got it at $774, $2,300, down $1,400, but again, over the last 2 years or a year or so, I get to hold it and still have the equity, but it does suck when they do collapse. And you can see some will never come back, and I'm fully aware of that one. Then Encino says I'm break even, $1,100 value, but this one was free shares. Bought the IPO, $7,800, sold 85 for $7,820, paid $20 to get $1,100 worth of free stocks. Then Box L up 17% on this one. This one was a small one, but again, this one we got to make free. Bought 1,000 shares for $2,077, sold out 600 for a $200 profit, and then got another $1,000 of free shares right there. Then A-Bus right here, what do we got? This one, another free shares, bought 500 of them for $450, $2,249, sold out another 300 for $200 profit. I like that $200 profit, if you couldn't tell. Got another $1,000 of free shares, or just about, so barely down on there. But again, I got all my cash back to go make a lot of other trades, but still get to hold equity. Then Neo, this was just the one share that, what's his name, but I think Lending Tips bought it that one. And now 6%, man. Screw you, man. Then Walgreens, this was a value rotation play. We put a little bit into this, got a good dividend on it, but 32% on this one. That was during the value rotation. AMC, we bought this August 2020, spent $1,500, got 800% return, literally $1,500 into $13,000. So not too bad. Another one, Aeson. This one has been going crazy. Bought 100 of these shares, $2,900. Got to make a $9,000 profit, and we're still holding it to this day. That thing is wrecking it. I clicked ASON twice, and then Palantir, similar one. Bought 100 shares for $10.40. It's worth $1,800 now, but these ones are also free. I bought the IPO, 200 shares at $20.80. Sold 100 shares at double the price, so I got my whole initial investment minus $40, but I got to keep 100 shares for free, and you see what they're worth now. So there's that one, and then our True Car. This one was because I had a dream. We were up on it for a little bit, but down $1,300. So everything else you got to see, but you're getting to see how all of this kind of comes together. But hopefully it gives you an idea of what I'm holding. Hopefully you could see where I stand coming into the end of the year, and hopefully you are now on board as we get ready for an exciting time. So I hope you're ready, and I better see you on stream in the morning, baby. Let's go.